Welcome to New Hampshire's Business. I'm Fred Coker. Business at the State House. It's a business-friendly legislature, and we're going to talk to two members of the House in just a minute about a bill that would study all the regulations on business in the state. Here is what it would do. House Bill 248 would set up a commission to study business regulations, things like workers' comp, licensing and classification of workers, worker safety, unemployment benefits, air quality, waste and hazardous materials, energy, construction, building, and life safety codes. With me to talk about this are two state representatives in the House of Representatives. They are Paul Mirsky, state representative from Enfield Center. Welcome, Paul.
Thank you.
And John Sabrowski, state representative from Bedford. Welcome.
Thank you, Fred.
Nice to have you. Before we get into the bill on the regulations in more detail, John, this past week a couple bills passed the House that are very significant to business.
Yes, there were a couple. The business atmosphere up there in the current House is really intense, Fred. It's a top priority. And I'll give you two examples. Last week, one bill that would increase the threshold amounts for taxation under the business enterprise tax passed overwhelmingly.
Okay.
Second one, another bill that changes the carry forward periods for the business enterprise tax credit against the business profits tax passed overwhelmingly.
Right.
And then we have a couple more following that, one having to do with increasing the net operating loss carryover under the BPT, and another reducing the rate of the business profits tax.
Right.
We are really focused on business.
Okay, that's interesting news for all those people in business that are watching. Paul, the bill that you and John have sponsored on looking at all the regulations, and there are a pile of them, on business in this state. How's that going to work if this passes?
Well, typically businesses come to the legislature with their own particular problems, and they try to get a small bill passed, and sometimes it usually gets lost. The purpose of this is to gather all the interest groups, retail, auto, construction, picket, Chambers of Commerce, BIA, get them all in the same room together as part of a commission, and then to work on the environmental regulation and work on the labor and workforce issues that you raised. The point being that by the end of, and through this commission, to develop an inventory of all the tax laws and regulations that are working against business, in October, come to the legislature with that report, and then produce as many repeal or regulatory changes as possible for the second year of the session. So I don't know how many bills that might wind up, but the idea is to try to do as comprehensively as possible so that we put a sign on New Hampshire that we're back in business.
Right. One of the problems, as you both know and as any CEO of a company in New Hampshire knows, if they have to go through the state for approval or permitting or something, the process takes too long. And sometimes they lose the project because of it, right?
Well, they lose the market, lose the project.
Yes.
Yeah. So that's one of the outcomes you want, I would assume, is to shorten the process.
Yes, absolutely.
What other changes would you like to see out of this commission study? Do you have any preconceived notions?
Well, one of the things I've heard we've talked about this with one of the senators, Senator Sanborn, they're talking about maybe one-stop shopping through for people who want to do projects, they only go one place to get regulatory clearing, for example. That might be one of the things that would come out of this. Hopefully, maybe we'd get a regulatory reform in wetlands. We'd get regulatory reform in fire and safety codes.
Yeah.
All of these things that inhibit getting to the market in a timely way.
I mean, one of the things the High Tech Council, which I'm part of, would like to see is looking at the economic impact of a regulation before you enact it. Because there isn't one.
One of the things that's so important with this, Fred, is that as we all know, the business profits tax and the business enterprise tax are the number one revenue generator for the state.
Mm-hmm.
And with this and the other business-oriented bills, we want to drive that source of revenue up so the state can then do all the other things that it would like to do and the citizenry of the state would like to see done.
And that is all the time we have. Paul Mirsky from the House of Representatives in Concord and John Sabrowski, state representatives, both of you. Thank you.
Thank you, Fred.
Nice to have you.
Thank you. You're welcome.
Good luck in the session. And if you want to see this interview again, you can go to WMUR.com. Just click on Project Economy.